Few gamers familiar with the 8-bit era will be unaware of Bubble Bobble and the cute dinosaur slash dragons Bob and Bob. It spawned a series of sequels, and the characters are probably most famous now for the Puzzle Bobble or Buster Move series. The evil Baron Von Blubber has transformed our heroes into bubble-blowing reptiles and captured their girlfriends in true 80s gaming style. So we're off to the Cave of Wonders to defeat BVB and get them back. This is a single-screen platformer, seeing you envelop your enemies in bubbles and then popping them to finish them off with the spikes on your back. Enemies burst and bubbles scatter fruit pieces that can be picked up for bonus points. Capture and burst all the enemies at once for big bonus fruit. There's a few power-ups here, though they don't appear to be triggered by specific actions like they are in the arcade version. There are more powerful bubbles, screen clears, level warps and others waiting to be found. There's also bonus letters to spell out extend. This gives you an extra life and warps you to the next level. If you can get a second player to give this a go, do so. It's the easiest way to progress. You can help each other by jumping off each other's bubbles, and the credit glitch that prevents you from using a continue isn't a problem, as long as you don't run out of lives at the same time. Take too long to clear a screen and the enemies will become angry. Change colour and move much faster. Take longer still and the Baron himself appears, slowly chasing you across the screen, immune to your bubbles. Time to hurry up and get those baddies popped. Yes, it has a cutesy theme, which isn't a style for everyone, but this harks back to a simpler time in gaming, where having fun with your friends and chasing high scores was just as important as completing games for the sake of it. It also has that replay factor, where you want to see what the next screen looks like, or what crazy power or bonus item might be. So you'll likely know this is one of the most popular C64 games, almost always coming up in the top 10 lists anywhere you might find them. Why then play this over the arcade version on MAME? Really, there's little between them. The C64 version has lost very little from the source, with only a few cuts to the presentation of the game. This game showcases what can be done on the C64 when the developer gets it right, and captures the essence of the arcade game and brings it to the home. You might also find that the SID chip makes that famous tune sound even better than ever. This is among the very best two-player games you can play on this system. Grab a friend and give it a go. If you've liked this video, please like and subscribe, and hope to see you next time.